So class 10, today we are going to revise. Afterwards we will have. So now we are going to revise 100 dresses. Okay, so the chapter we have revised. So let us go through the extracts first of all. Okay, the first extract, see in your books please. Wanda Pentronsky was not in her seat, but not even Peggy and Madeline. The girls who started all the fun noticed her absence. Usually Wanda sat. First extract. It is first extract, please. Page number it is 64. Page number is 64. No, Raghav. So the first extract is Wanda. Wanda Pentronsky was not in her seat, but nobody, not even Peggy and Madeline, the girls who started all the fun, noticed her absence. Usually Wanda's seat sat in the seat next to the last seat in the last row in room 13. She sat in the corner of the room where the rough boys who did not make good marks sat. The corner of the room where there was not much scuffling. Sorry, there was more scuffling and most roars of laughter when anything funny was said. And most mud and dirt on the floor. So first of all, if I will ask you who is the author of this chapter, nobody will know. Name the author. It is Eleanor S. Okay, Eleanor S. Okay, you should know. Where did Wanda Pentronsky sit? On the front bench. See the options. On the front bench, in the group of rough boys with Maddie and Peggy, or in the corner of the class? In the corner of the class. Yes, it is in the group of rough boys. It is also right. We can also consider it right. This is the reason she is right, because she was not included in that group. This is the reason why we are not choosing this option. Duck, stand up from there. In the corner of the class is the final answer. Yes, Pita, you go there. Ducks will come there. Go at the next desk. Next question is, why did Wanda sit alone in the corner of the class? Why she sits alone in the corner of the class? So there are four options. Just see. First option is, for her teachers made fun of her. For she made fun of her teachers. For everyone made fun of her. Or for she was so rich, so wanted to sit alone. Right. It is because of the reason, because everyone made fun of her and this is the reason why she's sitting alone. Next question is, see the next extract after it. Nobody knew exactly on the same page. See the extract on the same page. Nobody knew exactly why Wanda sat in that seat until it was because she came all the way from Boggins Heights and her feet were usually caked with dry mud. But no one really thought much about Wanda Pentronsky. And the time, just a moment, please. Yes, the time when they thought about Wanda was outside of school hours at noon time, when they were coming back to school, or in the morning early before the school began. When groups of two or three or even more would be talking and laughing on their way to the schoolyard. So which place did Wanda hail from? So where she hailed from? Hail from means that she comes from. So where she, okay, right. So where she comes from? It is Elegant Heights, Rocked Heights, Boggins Heights. Boggins Heights, right. Why was no one bothered about Wanda in the class? Why no one? See the options. See the options, please. For she was super rich, for she did not want to be disturbed, or for she came from poor family and lived alone, or for she was so beautiful. Why lived alone? Which option? B is for she did not want to be disturbed. Wrong. This is C option is the right one. C option is the right one. It means that for she hailed from poor family and lived alone. Next is, what did Brenda have in her closet? What she has? The 100 frocks, 100 tops, 100 shorts, 100 dresses. Why did others wait for Wanda? Options are to greet her, to make fun of her, to drop her, to make fun of her. So, the next extract is, I'm speaking the extract, otherwise it's difficult to find here. It is, she came to school alone and went home alone. She always wore a faded blue dress that didn't hang right. It was clean. Here it is, otherwise, I think so. She didn't have any friends, but a lot of girls talked to her. Sometimes they surrounded her in the schoolyard as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch on the worn hard ground. Which color dress did Brenda wear every day? It is the same faded blue dress, right? What is hopscotch? It is an exercise, a board game, or played with stone, or none of these? It is played with, a game played with stone, of course. What is the meaning of, or if I say replace, as though, what it means? As though means as to, as if, or as of. As if, right. As if is the right answer. Okay. So next extract is, 100 dresses, exclaimed all the girls. Let me find it out if it is there. Yes. Next extract is, 100 dresses, exclaimed all the little girls incredulously, and the little ones would stop playing hopscotch and listen. Ye 100 dress, all lined up, said Wanda, and her lips drew together in silence. What are they like? All silk, I bet, said Peggy. Yeah, all silk and all colors, and that of velvet too. Right? And Wanda would repeat solidly, all lined up in my closet. Then they would let her go, and then before she would gone very far, they couldn't help bursting into shrieks and peals of laughter. What has been referred to as a 100 dress? 100 dress means different kind of dresses that she has. Okay. What does the word incredulously mean? What is the meaning of incredulously? It is unbelievably, patiently, angrily, or cryingly. Unbelievingly. Right, it is unbelievingly. What does the phrase lined up mean? What it means, lined up? Unarranged, arranged, tied, or scrambled?
Arranged.
Arranged. Arranged is the right answer. Next one. The next is, next is, Peggy was not actually cruel. See the extract in the books. It's on page number 66. Peggy was not actually cruel. She protected small children from bullies, and she cried for hours if she saw an animal mistreated. If anybody has said to her, don't you think that it is a cruel way to treat Wanda? She would have been very surprised. Cruel. Why did the girl say she had 100 dresses? Anybody could tell her that she was a lie. Why did she want to lie? And she wasn't just an ordinary person. Else, why did she have a name like that? And anyway, they never made her cry. So what does the word bully mean? It is uncultured person, roughneck, ruffian, or all of these. What does word bully mean? Uncultured, roughneck, ruffian, or all of these. Okay, right. Next is, how was Peggy different from others? Options are, listen to me carefully. She was more angry than others. She was more caring than others. Or she was more daring than others. Or she was more caught than others. How's Peggy different? Last option, she's not caught. Options are, just listen to me, that she was more angry than others. She was more caring than others. She was more daring than others. Or she was more caught than others. She was more caring than others. Because in the extract, we have read that she could not be able to see or she could not see any animal mistreated lying on the roadside. She would take care of the animal. According to the extract, I'm asking. Okay? Next, afterwards, why couldn't everyone think that Vanda couldn't have 100 dresses? Why everyone was not thinking? Because for she was rich, for she was poor, for she was well established, or she was well off. She was poor. Okay, because she was poor, she is wearing the same faded blue dress daily. It is clearly mentioned. She lived at Boggins Height, where not much of the... What is the meaning of then rough voice? So why she is wearing that one dress daily? It is not directly mentioned, of course, but what we have interpreted in the end. This is the thing, what we have interpreted. We have interpreted about her background only this thing. When options are given, then you can. Otherwise, not. Next. Now, which of the following adjectives suits Peggy? Which adjective suits Peggy means? Which are the options fitting that to Peggy? She is cruelsome, tiresome, compassionate, and all of these. Tiresome, how she is tiresome? How she is tiresome, just explain me. If you are saying all of these, being tired. It is compassionate she was, according to the extract that I have explained. No, it's not all of these. Okay. So, according to the chapter, just give me the answer of few MCQs. What made Vanda leave her school? Why she left school? Due to stringent punishment given by her teachers, due to being ridiculed by her classmates, or due to her inability to pay her fee, or due to her not completing the work. Okay. So, the next extract is, listen to me. No. It was because she was being bullied. It is because of this reason that his father, Mr. Jan Pentronsky, he has taken away both the children, both Vanda as well as her brother. Okay, it is because of this reason that they left the city also. Yes? Yes. Vanda Pentronsky, Jan Pentronsky. Right? Next extract. The first period was a study period मैडी ट्राइड टू प्रिपेयर हर लेसन्स बट शी कुड नॉट पुट हर माइंड ऑन हर वर्क शी हैड अ वेरी सिक फीलिंग इन द बॉटम ऑफ हर स्टमक ट्रू शी हैड नॉट enjoyed listening to Peggy ask Vanda how many dresses she had in her closet but she had said nothing she was a card at least Peggy hadn't considered they were being mean but she Maddie had thought they were doing wrong so why was Maddie feeling sick in her stomach options are for Peggy had left the school for Vanda had left the school For a teacher had left the school, or for her father had left the job. No, it is because Vanda had left the school. She was not able to understand. Afterwards, please go. It is because of the reason because Vanda had left the school. This is the reason she was feeling herself to be guilty of that. She was feeling herself wrong also that she was an accomplice or she was accompanying Peggy in making fun of her. She was also visualizing herself to be the next victim. Who has been called as card in this extract? Raghav Sadhana, pay attention. Who has been called as card in this extract? Maddie, Peggy, Vanda or Miss Mason? It is Maddie. It's called. Who is called in this extract? Maddie or Peggy? It's Maddie. Afterwards, you can. Now, give the answer to this. What does the phrase "put herself in someone's shoes" mean? What is the meaning of put herself in someone's shoes? Options are to apologize, to feel as same as the other does, or to rejoice. B option. Right, B option is the right one, to feel someone as the same as other person. Next is, what was the name of their teacher? Mr. Keezing? Miss Mason, Miss Mabin, or Miss Mason. The next extract is the two girls hurried out of the building up the street towards Boggins Heights, the part of the town that wore such a forbidding air on this kind of November afternoon, drizzly, damp, and dismal. Well, at least, said Peggy gruffly, I never did call her a foreigner or make fun of her name. I never thought she had the sense to know. So now, listen further. And we were making fun of her anyway. I thought she was too dumb. And Gee, look how she can draw. So who are the two girls in this line? Yes, it's Peggy and Maddie, right? In which surroundings did Vanda put up in her locality? Dismal, damp, drizzly, all of these? It is all of these because all the three options are very much mentioned in the extract. If I will say drizzly, damp, and dismal, which literary device is used here? Drizzly, damp, and dismal. Alliteration. Very good. It is alliteration because there is predominance of the consonant sound D. Okay. What does the word dumb mean? It is mute, stupid, slow, or all of these? Mute, slow, stupid, all of these. All of these is the right answer. Now the next extract, days passed and there was no answer, but the letter did not come back, so maybe Vanda had received it. Perhaps she was so hurt and angry, she was not going to answer. You could not blame her. Weeks went by and still Vanda did not answer. Peggy had begun to forget the whole business, and Maddie put herself to sleep at night, making speeches about Vanda, defending her from great crowds of girls who were trying to tease her with, how many dresses have you got? So the first question is related to this extract. The first is, why was Vanda not replying according to them? Because she want, why now see why Vanda was not answering? Because she wanted to enjoy in the new city? Because she wanted to join the school again? Or she was hurt and angry? Or she was busy in knitting new dresses? Yes, because she was hurt and angry. So this is, yes? No, why? Okay. Huh? Angry is not mentioned, but why she was not answering? Okay, tell me. Suppose we have read the all. See, you are saying, okay, what you are saying, see the options. 1 minute, I am speaking the options again, then analyze. It is because she wanted to enjoy her new city, Raghav. She wanted to enjoy in her new city. This is wrong? Okay. Because she wanted to join the school again? No. Next option is because she was busy in knitting new dresses? No. The only option left is this. So this is right. Huh? Actually, none and all of these won't be given. Most of the time. You must have checked the paper. We are not giving all of these and none. Very rarely it is given. But when a quality MCQs are based, none and all of these are not to be given. Okay? And because she was hurt only, of course. She was angry. This is the reason why she has not written a letter to those girls. She could have written a letter to Penny and Betty also. She had the address. But why? And she has not even mentioned. Okay? When she has written a letter to Miss Pesson. She was hurt out. It was to Miss Pesson. Why she has written a letter to Miss Pesson? Just see why she has written a letter to Miss Pesson. She wanted to make them realize she has not written a letter directly to Maggie and Penny and Peggy. Why she has not written? She was hurt of their behavior. Huh? It was because she wanted to make them realize that if she is not having other dresses, that doesn't mean she doesn't have dreams. So next one. How did the girls tease Vanda? By misnaming her, pulling her braids, asking her how many dresses she has got, or telling her how many dresses she has got. How many dresses she has? Yes, this option can also be considered as right because they were asking her name. Okay, but actually in the chapter throughout we haven't read they were asking her name. Mainly they were asking how many dresses she has. Yes, her name was unique. This is the reason why they were making fun of her. It's a one of thing. Next is, who of the following was sympathetic towards Vanda? Maddie, Miss Pesson, Peggy.
Maddie.
What kind of dresses did Vanda have? Real dresses, drawings of dresses, designer. Drawings of dresses. She does not have real dresses. She was only drawing of dresses. Okay. Okay, which color dress did Vanda want Maddie to keep? It was blue or green one. And to Peggy, she has given the green one with red trimmings. Now the last extract, listen carefully. Tears blurred her eyes and she gazed a long time. And she gazed a long time at the picture. Then hastily she rubbed her eyes and studied it intently. The colors in the dresses were so so vivid that she had scarcely noticed the face and head of the drawing. But it looked like her. Why it really looked like her own self. Who is she in the first line? It was Maddy or Peggy? Who is she in the first line? It is Maddy. What does the verb intently mean? What is the meaning of intently? It is recklessly, carelessly, or arduously. Intently mean. What does intently mean? Recklessly, arduously, or carelessly?